Hi everyone, I'm Achilles from Suncord AudioLab Greece, and today we're going to talk about pseudo-stereo basics. Pseudo comes from the Greek word pseudo, which means fake, so it's like fake stereo, and these techniques are all about creating stereo sound out of mono, creating a stereo image out of mono image, or expanding the stereo image. Now, I usually use these techniques when working on restoring or mastering rehearsals, live shows, old recordings done with just one room mic, but I'm pretty sure you'll find many ways and reasons to use these techniques as well. So let's get started. This is our project. We have three tracks here. First one here is our reference, which is a normal stereo track with a stereo sound. As you can see here, its channel left and right contain different sound, different data. So let's listen. All right, let's move now to the next track, which is a stereo track, as you can see here. But if you open the waveforms and look closely, you can see that left and right channel are actually identical. It's the same data, the same sound. So don't ever get confused. This might be a stereo track, but it's actually a mono sound. Listen. So, there's a big difference between a stereo track and stereo sound. This is not stereo sound, this is mono. And let's listen now to the mono track, which actually sounds exactly the same as the stereo merge. So, this is the track we're going to work with, the mono track, but the stereo merge above is exactly the same. You can work with it the same way as this one. So, first thing you want to do is duplicate it. Right click here on the track, duplicate. That's the first step. Now, name one of them mono left and the other one mono right. Next step is panning those two. First one should go full left on the pan pot, which is right here. And the second one, of course, full right. Pan it full right. All right. And the next step is the most important step of creating the pseudo-stereo image. What you have to do is create a time difference between the two tracks. Here, I will start by adding 3 milliseconds of difference. That means that mono right will be 3 seconds in front of mono left. Let's listen. So, you can just start hearing the pseudo-stereo effect, but let me add some more time difference between them. Let's add some more, maybe 9 milliseconds, sounds good. Let's try 10. So, there's actually no rule. I like the 10 millisecond difference right now, and I will stick to the 10 millisecond difference. Next step. Let's cut this apart to process it. Right click, control right click, process, pitch correction. So, go here, select the best algorithm. Also very important is that you click time correction, because you don't want the algorithm to mess up with the playback speed. So let's go to fine tuning and add maybe 10, 20, maximum 30 cents. I will try 20. 20 usually works for me, but you can experiment with all of these values. Let's press apply new version. And as you can see, it needs a little bit time because the algorithm is complex. Okay, we're ready to go. Let's close the window and listen. All right. It sounds pretty stereo right now. We have finished all the basic steps of the pseudo stereo techniques, but let's try some more. Let's add some EQ separately to its channel. So left channel, maybe add some boost here. You can listen on the left channel. Now to the right. Right, boosting some cymbals on the right channel. Sounds good here. All right, I think I'm pretty satisfied right now. There are, of course, many things we can experiment with, but I think you got the idea. So that was it, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, please subscribe. Also, if you like the music we worked on, it's called Oral Haze. It's my electronic music project, and you can find more in the description box. See you soon. Cheers.